So I think that must be because of caching. So we'll go through only the finance part. So we'll ignore all of the other one, because since he's a super user, he's got access to other modules as well. So you can see this. Others will go only to finance. And so we have transaction, administration, masters, revenue collection, budgeting, reports. So this is, these are the sections which I have already listed out in the agenda of the schedule part. So we'll go through the masters, we'll take a break, and then go through the transaction other sections after that. Okay. I'll quickly finish up the master part. Let me do through the chart of accounts. This is the key master that is there for the financial module, which is like defined as per the NMAM standards or as per the NMAM requirement. So you can see there are four basic types of account heads, or 1, 2, 3, 4, which is income, expense, liability, asset. And these are the major codes, and which is completely in line or in sync with NMAM. This cannot be changed because NMAM says that, you know, this should be the same across all the states. Okay. And these are the minor codes. This again, the NMAM says that, you know, it's better states don't change it. But there is, NMAP says there is a flexibility of allowing states to add and modify certain minor codes. But now, since it's going on a common platform, or since reporting becomes easier, and there are various dashboards that is aimed at interstate level, it is advised that, you know, states also don't change these minor codes and adopt the same thing across. These are the detailed codes which can be specific to the implementation, so that even their reporting within the state will be standard and can be compared across ULBs if they are of the same structure and same naming conventions and codifications. Okay, which means that, you know, 1110101 property tax general should be property tax general across all ULBs. So in many cases, like, you know, there will be a smaller panchayat which will say, I don't have certain type of income codes at all. So that doesn't mean that they don't get those codes. So they also have to use that, but they can ignore and bucket their revenue in certain GL codes only. Okay. So this is the detail code at which the posting happens. Okay. And these are major and minor code at which the posting or transaction are not created, but used only for the reporting, summation, or grouping of detail code for generating various types of reports. The schedules in balance sheet are defined at this level, and subschedules are defined at this level. Income expenditure statement, P&L statement also has got schedules with the income and expense code, and balance sheet will have schedule defined at this level, considering liability and asset codes. Okay. Fine. Okay. So detail code is to fetch a particular respective detail code and modify it accordingly. So you also have a COA report, which will basically fetch or allow user to search COA based on various criteria. So you will see the same thing what you see in the tree structure on top. This is the information that is captured as part of the detail code. So there is account code name, descriptions, a detailed description for the account code type, what type of code it is, whether it's a liability or asset, and so on. Classification, whether it's a detail code, minor code, and so on. Purposes, there are for automatically loading certain types of GL codes. For example, in contractor bill, payable code is automatically fetched. So those are identified using this purpose IDs. So right now, this is not linked to a purpose. So no screen or no process will be using this code to fetch automatically in any of these screens. Account detail type, this is like sub-ledger posting. In case this contractor payable code, or you have supplier payable, and you have deductions, statutory deductions against contractors. So you want to track those information or those ledger posting by contractors also. Then you can link it, account detail type can be mapped to a contractor. So that posting, whenever the posting is taking place for this code, it will also, the ledger engine will also request for detail code wise or like, you know, contractor wise bifurcations for that particular amount, right? So that means the posting into ledger happens by contractor as well. This is for budget, whether budget check is mandatory for this code or not. There can be a universal flag set whether budget check should happen on all transactions or not. And there is a code-wise, chart of account code-wise or detail code-wise check wherein configuration wherein you can say whether budget check should happen for this. Okay. Similarly, in the budget check, whether you want to do the budget check by function or not, that also can be done. So this is an important master. That's the reason we need to